soul of God, joy like a river, joy like a river, joy like a river in my soul. Hallelujah. God, joy like a river, joy like a river, joy like a river in my soul. God, joy like a river, joy like a river, joy like a river in my soul.
Hallelujah. We are acting as if we are not experiencing joy, and we are in the house of the Lord Almighty. We are in the presence of the Lord. When you are in the presence of the Lord, there's liberty, deliverance, healing. Amen. So because of that, I want you to be excited. I want you to be moved. Amen. Show it. Let that joy come, and let it come out of you. Amen. Joy like a river, joy like a, hallelujah, joy like a river in my soul. I've got joy like a river, joy like a river, joy like a river in my soul. Joy like a river, hallelujah, joy like a river, oh, joy like a river in my soul. God, joy like a river, joy like a river, joy like a river in my soul. Cast your body unto Jesus, for he cares for you. Cast your body unto Jesus, for he cares for you. Aya, 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 Jesus, aya, 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 Jesus, aya, 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 Jesus, aya, 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 Jesus, no one, no one, no one, no one. No one, Satan, no one, no one, no one, no one, no one, Satan, no one. Aya, 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 Jesus, aya, 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 Jesus, aya.
Father, in the mighty name of Jesus. Father, in the mighty name of Jesus, our Lord and our God, we thank you, we bless your holy name this morning. Father, be exalted in the mighty name of Jesus. Lord, as we are going into your word, I pray that your word will come out with might, strength, and power in the mighty name of Jesus. Transform lives, Lord. Let your people be blessed. Through this word, let there be transformation. Father, we bless your holy name. In Jesus' name, we worship. Amen. Let us all be seated. Good morning, people of God. Good morning, my fathers in the Lord. I am excited to be in the house of God this morning, and I thank God Almighty, and I thank our fathers for this great opportunity to speak to our people, the people of God, children of God. The Lord has laid it in my heart this morning to talk to you about worry. Amen? And the title is taken from my new book, chapter 6, Why Worry When You Can Pray? Can
Can we repeat it? Why do I have to worry? Can we say after me? Why do I have to worry when I can pray? Again, why do I have to worry when I can pray? The word of God is coming to you this morning. Why do you have to worry when you can pray? I have preached this before, but I don't know why God asked me to repeat this particular sermon this morning. This message is for someone this morning. I remember the first time I preached this particular theme, this particular sermon. It was a difficult situation, a situation where I found myself in encouraging people. A situation whereby almost about 20 or 15 people were moved from that facility to nowhere. When people woke up, they woke up and found out that most of their friends were no around, they were no more. A situation whereby there was no hope. And God told me to talk to the people in that particular prayer group. Say, why worry when you can pray? They thought I was crazy when I said that. In that evening, I said, you are supposed to be rejoicing, no mourning. Wake up, brother and sister. Why worry when you can pray? If Lord is for you, who can be against you? Devil cannot overpower you. Devil cannot come against you. Amen? From that chapter that I'm talking this morning, it said there are two things, worry and prayer. Prayer is very important in the lives of all Christians. Prayer is a way that we communicate with our God. And when we pray, we speak, we talk, and we do what? We make our requests known to God Almighty. Children of God, the Bible makes us to understand that prayer helps us to lift up our souls. Amen? Is the what? A lifting up our souls to God. Prayer helps us to lift up our souls to God Almighty. Let us quickly look at the book of Psalms, chapter 25, verse 1. Book of Psalms, chapter 25, verse 1. It says, to you, O Lord, I lift up my what? My soul. Oh my God, I trust in you. Children of God, God is your heavenly Father. And through prayer, you are able to lift up your soul to Him. You bring every worry, you bring every anxiety unto God. And when you do that, you're telling God that I want you to be in control. I'm giving you everything about me. You're lifting your soul to Him, the Redeemer, the only one that can save you. You are telling Him you are the Supreme God who can save and can deliver. Amen? Amen? Prayer gives us the ability to pour our heart to God. To do what? To pour our heart to God. And that can be found in book of Psalm 62, verse 8. Let us quickly look at that. 62, verse 8. Psalm 62, verse 8 says, trust in Him. Amen? At all times, you people, pour out your what? Heart before Him, because God is a refuge for what? For us. The word of God says, pour out your heart unto Him, before Him, because He is your refuge. Children of God, if the Bible tells you, not even if, the Bible tells you that you should pour your heart to Him because He is your refuge. Amen? And if the word of God says so, nothing can erase it. So why do you worry when it has already been established that you should pour your heart unto Him because He is your refuge? In time of trouble, even when you are joyful, pour your heart to Him. When you are sorrowful, pour your heart to Him because He is your refuge. In every situation you find yourself, pour your heart to Him. He can protect you, He can guide you, He can see you through. And when the word of God says so, it is so, it is established. Amen? So why do you worry when you can pray? If we all know all these things about prayer, from the lesson we read, the word of God says, ask and it will be given unto you. The word of God does not say, ask and nothing can, it will be done. It says, ask and it shall what? Be given unto you. It says, seek and you will find. Because if you seek, you will surely find. That's the word of God. Amen? God is asking you. that if you knock, the door will be open to you. So why don't you pour your heart, bring all worries, all cares unto him, and only him who can deliver. Amen? Amen?
So in summarize, if you look at the whole thing, we are talking about prayer. In summarize, prayer means communion and communication. Communion means establishing relationship with your God. And communication means having, it means exchanging words with God.
To and fro, dialogue, not monologue.
Amen?
You pray to him. Through your prayer, you communicate. You talk to him. You bring your supplication unto him.
And in return, if you carefully listen in your prayers, what happens?
The Lord will answer. The result of your prayer is that God does what? He listens and hears and responds. And when he responds with result.
Amen? So when you believe, when you know as Christian that God will respond with what? Positive response. God will return your prayers with positive response. Why don't you bring all your cares, all your worry unto him?
Because he can save you. Because he's able to deliver you from every situation that you are going through.
Amen?
So, people of God, when we pray, we humbly come to him. We affectionately come to God Almighty to help us, to deliver us, to rescue us, and to assist us.
Amen?
Amen?
Matthew 21, verse 22, it says, and whatever you ask in prayer.
Amen?
Pastor already completed it for us. Quickly, as I'm giving all these Bible verses, I want us to be following the word of God. Amen? Matthew 21:22. Let us quickly go, and somebody should please read this for us to hear. Matthew 21:22. Slowly, my brother. Hold on, my brother. My brother is saying, the Bible says, and in all things. He said, in something. In one thing, right? He said, in all what? All things. Continue, my brother. The word of God is saying, believing, you shall what? Receive.
That's it.
He said, believing that you will what? You will. If God assures you that you should bring all your care to him.
Amen?
If he's telling you that bring everything unto him, and whatever you ask, you shall receive. Why do you have to worry then? Why do you have to worry? As long as you have God's backing, you have his support, life is simple for you. The funniest thing is worry. It's part of life. The thing that we need to understand as Christians is that we should not worry too much.
Amen?
You should not what? It's part of life. It's part of development. Part of growth. But the most important thing for us as Christians to understand is we should not worry too much. Because when you worry too much, you bring anxiety, depression, fear into your life. And God does not want that for you. That's why you are a child of God. That's why you are a believer. Amen? So enjoy in this situation. Just pray. Don't worry too much. Amen? Commit it to God's hand because he's able and he will do it. James 5, 13 to 15. I don't want us to quickly see that. Just listen. James 5, 13. He's talking about someone who is sick. He said, if someone is sick, bring that person to the elders. Amen? And they will do what? They will pray and anoint the person. Amen?
And when you bring the sick to the elder, they'll pray and do what? And anoint the person. The Bible does not say after prayer, after anointing, what happened? Be worried. It did not say that. So why do we worry when we can pray?
There's power in prayer. Because prayer holds the key of the mysteries of life. It holds the key to the mysteries of life.
He holds the key to what? The mysteries of life. There are hidden things in life that you cannot, you may not know. It can only be revealed to you through what? Prayer. There are things hidden that may not be exposed to you, but through prayer, it will be revealed to you. Those things will be revealed to you. So there's power in prayer. There's blessing in prayer. There's promotion in prayer. Prayer unfolds, unlocks blessing, prosperity, promotion, deliverance, and many more in the lives of Christians. Amen? So children of God, when we know these things, why do you worry when you can pray? Children of God, this morning, I want to encourage you that rather than worry, you must pray without ceasing. Amen? 1 Thessalonians chapter 5, 16 to 17. If you see, please read. First Thessalonians chapter 5, 16 to 17. The word of God is saying, rejoice. My brother, hold the thought. It said rejoice. In bad situation, do what? Rejoice. It's not saying worry. He said, rejoice always. And so? In bad situation, rejoice always. In good situation, rejoice always. Amen? Amen? Pray without ceasing. That's the word of God. Children of God, will you pray this morning? Will you cast all your worry unto him this morning? He said, rejoice always. Children of God, in any situation you find yourself, instead of worrying too much, I want to encourage you this morning that celebrate God. You must do what? You must celebrate God. When you celebrate him, you worship him, you praise him, you exalt his holy name. Amen? When you do that, you have the conviction within you that God Almighty is able, he can do it for you. Regardless of your surrounding, regardless of your circumstances, regardless of what is going on in your life. Rejoice always. Amen. Celebrate God, people of God. 1 Peter chapter 5, verse 7. Casting all your worry, all your care unto him. Because he what? He cares for you. Sometimes we find ourselves in a situation where we have no control over, and you worry, are you going to get out of that terrible situation? But if you put all your worries, if you put all your cares onto him, he will get you out, because you are his child, you are his son, or you are his daughter. He will do what? He will get you out of that situation. He will surely get you out of that situation. That's why that passage, 1 Peter says, casting all your worry onto him because he cared for you. Why worry? Well, you can pray. The book of John chapter 14, 13 says, the promise of God is, why you worry? When the Bible says, whatever you ask in my name, I will do it. So that the Father Almighty can be glorified in the Son. Amen? So why do you worry too much when you can pray? Children of God, the word of God is coming to you today. Worry less, pray more. Amen? Worry what? Worry less, pray more. I learned that a lot in my life, my personal life. Pray more, worry less. That's the message of God for you today. Children of God, in your relationship with God Almighty, or let me put it, there are two people. The first one, people who don't know God, and people who know God. People who do not know God, you need to identify God today. And those of us who know God, we need to improve our relationship. With who? With God Almighty. By coming closer to him. Meditating in his word and doing it accordingly. Amen? Amen? Let us develop or improve our relationship with who? With God Almighty. When we do that, we will worry less. We need to continually seek Him. And when we continually seek Him in words, in prayer, the Holy Spirit will continue to build us, will continue to teach us, and will continue to love Him more and worry less in our life. Psalm 50, verse 15. It says, call on me in the day of what? Trouble. I will deliver thee, and thou shalt glorify who? Glorify me. The word of God says, call upon me in the day of trouble. So when you are going through any situation, call upon Him, because His word says He will deliver you, and He will surely deliver you in the mighty name of Jesus. Amen? Children of God, now to anxiety, to worry. Worry means what? Anxiety. When you worry, what happens? You are nervous. You are anxious. It increases your blood pressure. Amen? It does what? It increases your blood pressure. And all those things, all those symptoms, diseases and stuff like that, they affect our immune system. They affect our body. Amen? So, in order to avoid all of those things, we need to what? Worry less. We need to worry less. When we have issues at home, issues with our children, let us worry less. Concerning our jobs, let us worry less. When you worry less, you pray more. The power to be able to pray fervently, the Lord will give unto us in Jesus' name. Children of God, as I'm winding up right now, I want to make this statement quickly. As children of God, many times we worry too much. And we find ourselves worrying about something that the Lord has already taken care of. The only thing is for it to be revealed. Amen? For the naked eyes to see. We don't know. In the spiritual realm, the Lord Almighty has already taken care of all those worries. Just for them to be what? Materialized, to be seen. And as Christians, we get worried. We get worried. We are troubled. I want to make this statement. If it's about job, if you think you had a good job and was taken away from you, it's like this. When you have a diamond and it's taken away from you, I've said this before, the Lord will give you what? A gold to replace it, because you are worshiping an awesome God. And when you have a gold and it's taken away from you, the Lord will surprise you with a platinum. Amen? So why do you worry when you can pray? And in conclusion, Romans 8:28. Children of God. In conclusion, you should know that all things work together for good to those who love God, to those who are called according to His purpose. Let us rise.